Tenele Karunaratna. Honorable Secretary of the Ministry of Higher Education, Dr. Sunil Jayantanavaratna. Dean of the Faculty of Management Studies and Commerce, Professor Sampath Amritunga. Dean of the Faculty of Applied Sciences, Professor Sudhanta Linnage. Dean of the Faculty of Graduate Studies, Senior Professor Swarna Piyasiri. Registrar of the University, Mr. Bittu. Senior professors, heads of departments, and other academic and non-academic members of my faculty, dear parents, and my dear students. At the outset, may I, on behalf of our faculty, offer you a very warm welcome. In line with the vision of our faculty, which is to be rated as the best medical faculty in Sri Lanka and one of the best in South Asia, we, the staff of this faculty, are committed to produce doctors competent in knowledge and skills, compassionate in their attitudes, respecting the needs of the patients and the society. We also believe that it is our responsibility to create the doctors with the right mindset. My dear students, today is the day you begin this long journey. Traditionally in this faculty, we invite an outstanding professional personality to deliver the commencement lecture, the very first formal lecture to medical students. This has been our practice because this faculty does not believe in producing doctors with mere medical knowledge and medical skills. We also wish to inculcate in the professional approach to life and work to meet the challenges of the 21st century. Professional approach to practice, the art of medicine, we believe, is an essential prerequisite to develop such medical personalities who will fit in to any part of this globe. Today, we are honored to have with us our invited guest speaker to deliver the commencement lecture, Dr. Sunil Navaratna, and it is my privilege to introduce him to you. Dr. Sunil Jayantanavaratna, MA, PhD, is the Secretary of the Ministry of Higher Education. He is a proud product of St. Mary's College, Kegon, who topped the 1973 batch of students of BSc Business Administration of the University of Sri Jayawardenepura. He passed out with honors, winning the top of the batch award for the 1973-77 batch. His high academic credentials saw him being selected to the final 6 out of 600 applicants to win the Monbushu Japanese Government High Educational Scholarship to do master's degree in management, which gave him MA economics degree from Kagawa University, Japan. He was awarded T. Ito N scholarship to do PhD studies in management and Kendran scholarship for postgraduate students. In 1993, he was awarded PhD in management from Keio University, Tokyo. He also has a diploma in Japanese language from Osaka University of Studies. These achievements saw him on return being appointed as the youngest secretary in Sri Lankan public sector in the year 2000 by His Excellency the President. Prior to his present appointment, he has held many prestigious positions in public and private sector. He was a chairman, Center for Strategic Management, Sri Lanka, Director General and Chairman, National Youth Services Council, Sri Lanka, Secretary, Ministry of Samurdhi, Rural Development, Upcountry Development and Parliamentary Affairs, Director General of the Samurdhi Authority, Sri Lanka, and Director, Human Capital, Youth Development and Rural Networks, CARG. He is a sought-after speaker in national and international business forums. He is a visiting faculty member for Masters in Business Administration program of the Faculty of Management and Finance of the University of Colombo on Strategic Management and Poverty Reduction from year 2000 up to this date. Dear sir, We are honored and privileged to have you to deliver the commencement lecture for the Faculty of Medical Sciences 2013. On behalf of my faculty, most sincerely thank you for accepting our invitation.
I won. Good morning. Vanakkam. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you very much for inviting me today to deliver this inaugural lecture. Professor Mohan De Silva, Dean of the Faculty of Medical Sciences, and all the other deans, Dean of Management Sciences, Dean of Science and Dean of Postgraduate Studies. I don't see the Dean of Art Faculty, and also Registrar, Bursa, and all the professors, Head of Departments, and dear future leaders of this country and their parents. So my topic today is somewhat different, because Professor Mohan always says that we should produce somewhat innovative, creative, different graduates from our Faculty of Medical Sciences. I'm also very happy to be here because I'm also a product of same university, Javadarpura. And Ola, I think, except Sarna. Sarna also not, you know. Okay. Peradirin. And so our minister also from same university. And not only that, but also the education minister also from the same university. Deputy minister also, yes. And there are many ministers in this cabinet. For example, Reginald Kure, Chandrasri Gajadira, Rajit Simbalapitiya, and also Lalit Dissanayaka, Kulanath Mira. There are big list. I'm not going to list out. But anyway, and there are many professors, big leaders, secretaries, and all. Leaders. So with that background, so I'm going to talk something different. How to become a professional plus effective leader is the topic. So definitely you are going to be professionals, and becoming an effective leader is that not easy, because sometimes only one professor can become the dean, only one can become the vice chancellor. Only one person can become, out of many, a secretary or minister, many. So therefore, I'm going to talk today how we are going to produce, or how you are going to be an excellent professional plus an effective leader. So here you can see the leader, and also here teamwork. If you want to become a good leader or professional plus leader, you have to identify leader plus leader in you. Every person has a leader. So leadership qualities and the teamwork is the key, and there are many things we are going to talk later on. So lecturing versus problem-based learning. Earlier it was learning, now it's problem-based learning. The lecturer also working as a partner. So small things together. Great things are not done by impulse, but by a set of small things brought together. So I'm going to teach you these small things which synergize and make you a future leader plus a future excellent professional. What is expected by a student to enter the university? As you know very well, 300,000 students are sitting for the A-level, and 130,000 getting the minimum qualifications. Only 27,000 could enter the university this year, but last year only 22,000, and out of that only 1,200 medical students go to the medical faculties, and only very few come to Jayawardenepura, Colombo and Kelaniya. So you are among top 300. So that is the secret, because others have to go to Rohuda and Batiklo, Jaffna and Peradeniya and all. Rajarata? Right. So therefore, the top notch of the, I call it real cream of the cream. So therefore, I think you have to have a dream to become an excellent leader. You are the future leaders of this country. Finally, you all try to be a leader or manager. Maybe in your words, we call DMOs, SHS, directors, head of department, deans, vice chancellors. I'm going to tell a few chairmen, consultants, advisors, additional secretaries, secretaries, WHO reps, ministers, etc., even World Bank and all these things. But only few can become, because there's a pyramid. Always there's a pyramid. Those who have technical, human, plus conceptual skills can achieve that. So university gives the technical skills. At the same time, you acquire your human and conceptual skills. So if you're getting only the technical skills, then you are a just doctor, no more than that. That is the secret. So I'm going to explain how you're going to achieve that. Education and knowledge plus skills. Education is a very broad term which involves both teaching and learning. So not teaching, but learning is very important. Remember, underline the learning. It is the process by which an individual acquires habits, skills, knowledge, values, attitudes, and mindsets. So all these things are matters a lot when you go forward as a leader. Skills or expertise is very important and acquired by individuals through the education process and experiences, both theoretical and practical knowledge, learning of facts and information in the field. So there's an art and science of the leadership. We can teach, that is the scientific part, but balance has to be your art. Art. We cannot teach, that is built in your body. So you know the science and the art, then you are going to be a successful leader. So I'm going to teach you the scientific part, but balance is up to you. Don't blame me, I didn't teach you everything. Okay. I can't. So can be concluded that needs education to gain knowledge of already exists. So we can learn the knowledge already exists, that is through books and journals and through the professors. So as to future, further knowledge by his or her own effort through innovation. Not only learning the available knowledge, but also you have to innovate some new knowledge. That is also important. Otherwise, if you are not creating anything new, you are just hanging around and maintaining. Therefore, especially universities has a bigger role to innovate new knowledge, do research, publications, and inculcate novel thinking. Don't try to import everything from USA or England. We can teach many things to them through our country's expertise. So our country is one of the best countries, but we have not modeled our theories, our framework, our principles, our things to sell or give it to the others. Therefore, I here emphasize, just finish, just learning through books and others, also you have to create something from your own. That is also very important. I know there are good professors, lecturers who are doing a lot of research in this university. In that sense, I'm proud, but as student, you should know this. Otherwise, you will come to know that in late hours. I'm going to introduce two very important two words. That is effectiveness and efficiency. In singular, we call effectiveness is sapaladayitave and efficiency is karyakshamatave. Since our parents are there, sometimes I will use singular, but forgive me, I don't understand Tamil. So effectiveness is to do the right thing, hari dekirim. And efficiency is do the things right, hari vidyata kirim. Hari de, hari vidyata kirim. So do the right and do the things right. Do the things right and do the right thing. So as far as thing is concerned, there hari de tiro, varad de tiro. We have right thing and wrong thing. At the same time, we can have right way and wrong way. Therefore, as the leader, your challenge is to do the right thing in right way. At the same time, there are three more options. You can do the wrong thing in right way, and you can do the right thing in wrong way, and do the wrong thing in wrong way. So now, if I ask you a question, what is the percentage we are doing the right thing in right way in country as a whole? As a whole, what is the percentage we are doing the right thing in right way? So if you can make it more than 90%, 70%, 80%, that is very good. That is what we have to do. So what is the percentage we are doing the right thing in right way at the university? At the university, at the faculty, at the department, as a person? You can question same thing as far as individual is concerned, department is concerned, and faculty is concerned, university concerned, a nation concerned, and ministry concerned. So this is a good model. So if you are doing, say, 50% right thing in right way, the balance 50% maybe we are doing the wrong thing in right way. So what you have to do, get the thing right, get the thing corrected. We are doing the wrong thing right way, no, wrong way. So you have to get the things, way of doing things corrected. If you are doing both, so always try to focus toward the left-hand corner, left-hand corner. So how do we decide what is correct and what is wrong? How do we? So that is very important. We should know our objective, vision, mission, goals and objectives. So we can find out what is correct to my achieve my goals. That is very important. I will ask you a question. What is the worst thing we can do in our world? The killing a person. Killing a person. But I will give you, a killing a person also can be justified. For example, when we kill LTT terrorist, no one blame. Everybody. Why? Objective was to safeguard our country from terrorism. So if you can justify a killing a person, you can justify anything, but provided that you have a clear vision, goals and objectives. Therefore, the correct thing and wrong thing is defined by the vision, mission, goals and objectives. So you have to have a vision for your organization, faculty, department, as well as your life. If you want to become a doctor, what kind of doctor? That is your vision. Or just an ordinary doctor going to the village and doing PP, or just a completely different doctor who is delivering something new, something innovative, who is not going behind money only. Today we have a big complaint against doctors. We are producing only people very selfish, only money-minded. They are not worried about others. They are not worried about responsibility. So are we going to do that? I am sure Jadavpur is producing a great different kind of professionals. I am happy to see that. So there are many evidence to show that. So even recently we hired, recruited few foreign students. So there was no issue. Some universities were trying to make it a issue. So I'll come to this topic later when it is necessary. So what is the management? So since our management dean is here, leading a team to achieve plan objectives. Leading a team to achieve plan objectives is the management or leader. So in other words, we have resources and people given. So now from the government we will give money and resources, buildings, computers, students, etc., etc. And what are your planned objectives? If you don't know your objectives, very difficult. Therefore, you should clearly define what are the goals and objectives you are going to achieve by using these resources and people. So if you want to achieve these planned objectives, then very important thing is leading. You have to lead. As a leader, you have to select, you have to focus, you have to guide the people and achieve the results. If you are not leading properly, you are not going to achieve results. Therefore, this is the key. People and resources are given, very limited. We cannot have unlimited people and resources. Plan objectives are given, and we should communicate it properly. Otherwise, nobody knows what is our objectives by using these resources. So if you want to achieve, important thing is the leading. Leader should be a good communicator. He should be a good leader with teamwork and plan and delivering results and with confidence. There are many things. So therefore, if you are not going to be a good leader, you are not achieving, so we are wasting our valuable resources. So you can have a selection. Whether you are going objective leader or not is the answer. You can be one more person or you can be excellent manager leader. So this is a car. Always I have asking from our academics, are you going to buy a car like this? Normally never, because this highly outdated, very old-fashioned car. So if you are going to import a car, these days I am issuing vehicle permits every day. This kind of car. It's a modern car, right? So university also should produce this modern type of product or professional, not this old type of products. So that is my question. So are we producing this kind of modern type of products? Okay, new outcome, new processes. So if you want to produce this kind of modern power steering, power shutters, automatic turbo, ABS, airbags, stereo, various things, then you have to have different process. If you have the old type of same process, you are producing old type of vehicle. Therefore, I'm sure Jadavpura medical faculty especially is in this novel process, producing the novel professionals with these leadership qualities and all these options. So older professionals versus new professionals. So that is what we should think. So what kind of graduates are we producing now? I'm not talking about Jadavpura, but some faculties are producing this kind of graduates. They are young, but mentally we are old. It's out of dated. So we should not produce this kind of graduates. I know there are professors and lecturers who are reading the same notes. They have class. Then they have psych. Not Sampath. I was see, in science he showed me Sampath. I know he's one of the best lecturers. No? So are we going to produce this kind of dynamic graduates in the question? So that is what, because without knowing us, so we might produce this kind of all things, believing it is modern. So that is the, so it is out of date. If then, so young all graduates, they are young but mentally they are old, but not because of the process, they are responsible, but our universities should take the responsibility. Because universities are the people who produce the curriculum, teach, have exams and giving them the qualifications. Students are innocent. So, therefore, Honorable Minister always says, universities should take the responsibility that producing the right product with right skills and mindset. So knowledge is outdated. Sometimes they are having very old thinking. When we introduce interview for Japanese and various scholarship, first classes, sometimes they don't know many things. They don't know many things. But that is our responsibility. If our first class is not knowing anything, that is our responsibility, not students' responsibility. Why we have given them a first class? That is the question we should ask. Theory only, high teacher-centered, teacher is giving everything. So now it's learner-centered, so we have to shift it. And no critical or logical thinking, they are not asking questions, they are not supposed to ask questions. But university should promote more and more dialogue between, and they should ask various questions, and they should question our present system. Then only we can produce novel thinking, novel models, novel theory. And not motivating to think anew and innovate, and not results-oriented and practical. Just maintaining the things. So we should break away from that. So I'm going to give you a few examples. Now, is there anyone who is using a film roll for the last 1 year? Is there anyone who have bought film rolls? If Kodak continuously producing film rolls, what is going to happen? No business. Now world is digital. There is no market for film rolls. So predicting that, we should produce digital cameras. Maybe we don't know, but we have to acquire the knowledge. So that is the secret of survival and future development. So same thing can be applied to the universities, faculties, departments, lectures, lecture notes, contents, way of doing things. So we have to ask the same question, are we doing this? I'm sure in some courses we have to do this. But unfortunately, some courses are not demanded. So they are doing the same old-fashioned things. The old-fashioned land phone, I think even our sons and daughters have not seen even this. Now we have seen this one, mobile phone. Multipurpose, the convergence is the key. I'm not promoting Nokia, this is the only photograph. Convergence is the key. What do you mean convergence? Convergence means we add everything together. There's a global market, continuously improving, total communication system, phone, still camera, video, radio, TV, audio recorder, computer, internet, SMS, MMS, web, everything there. So in this machine, I can do everything. I can see emails, I can write emails, all these things. So this is going to be the future education tool. They might not come to the lecture, they might listen to a lecture through mobile. So that kind of future is there. So are we ready to adopt this novel technology? So improving leadership and soft skills of the graduate is the key. So soft skills is a matter of thinking. I'm sure all of these graduates come through leadership training. So we introduced Excellency the President and the Honorable Minister decided to introduce leadership training to break away that old-fashioned thinking. So you should work with people, you should work with problems and resolve their problems effectively as teams. And somebody should lead. Maybe you lead now, maybe after 1 hour, separate one leading, dynamic leadership. So various research, we have found that employers' expectations are different from available graduates' quality and skills. I'm talking about the total outcome. So these are the qualities expected by the any public sector or private sector employers. Even me, even Professor Mohan, vice chancellor, Dr. Karunaratne, even deans, anyone. Number one is initiativeness. Something self-initiative. Most of the time, when we tell something, after 1 week or 1 month, when I ask, they have not done anything. The initiative is not there. So initiativeness is the key if you want to become a successful leader or even employer. Then the flexibility. Don't be strict. You have to have flexibility. And also adaptability. Depending on the situation, don't complain to the environment. You have to adapt, and that is the leadership training. You go to Diatalawa or Nuwara, very cold. When you go to Trincomalee, very hot. You have to adapt. Don't complain. That is adaptability. Responsibility. Take the responsibility and run. Decision making, problem solving, creativity. These are the matters expected as soft skills. So do you have this? How are we going to inculcate during our 4 years of time, in addition to the theoretical and practical of medicine? That is the key. So don't wait until the professors teach you, you have to acquire. That is the way. Sometimes it may be built in. Sometimes you may have to acquire. Then top 10 most important skills and capabilities when recruiting new graduates. It's a research done by a London-based company. It is common for everybody, even in Sri Lanka itself. Communication skill is the highest. Any employer, any researcher, any vice chancellor, any dean, when you hire a person, number one is communication. In Sinhala, Tamil or English, or if possible all three, that's great. But there are graduates who are coming out of the universities who cannot communicate even in Sinhala or Tamil. That is the problem. I will tell you why. Then the teamwork skills and leadership, again. Number two, integrity. Integrity matters a lot. Integrity means honesty, and we call avankabhave. Intellectual ability. Think a novel way, out of the box. And confidence. If you cannot tell something confidently and with confidence, we feel something wrong. Then we have to have confidence. Then for that, you have to have experience. You have to, should have done something in the history. Otherwise, you don't have character, personality, planning and organizational skills, literacy, good writing skills, numeracy, good with numbers, analysis, decision making and skills. So these are the 10 skills. So what is happening in a lecture, especially in the art faculties? Lecturer come and delivering a lecture. Then student will jot down and learn by heart and rewrite in the exam. So, lecturer come and deliver a lecture. So how can you improve the communication skills? No, you are good listeners, but even not good, because sometimes you are not getting the same theory or lecture. So we are producing listeners, not communicators. So we have to break it. How are you going to break? I will tell you later. And teamwork. So just listening to a lecture, can you create teamwork? Got to break it. So planning and organization skills, delivering resource skills. So those things has to be inculcated in our arts faculty especially. How are you going to do that? I'll tell you my experience, then you can think how we are going to adopt it. I was lecturing at NIBM for Ireland program during the weekend, Saturday and Sunday. I was teaching strategic management for IT students. So there were 130 students in the class. What I did was, on the very first day, I went to the class by 8:55. 9 is the starting time. Then people used to come 9:10, 9:15, like that. So all the latecomers should come to the stage and should sing a song or dance. Then from next day, no latecomers. Very simple, right? So changing the behavior is very. So no latecomers, nothing. Then I decided to have a leader. Suddenly I told them to write a name, who should be the leader. They everybody write a name, and finally I selected the leader without any pre-planning a contest. They themselves selected the leader. Then I select 10 groups, 13 into 10. Each group, 13 and 10 groups. Then I distributed a textbook to all, and everybody should read the textbook and summarize the chapter 1 and make a presentation and get ready to do that presentation in front of the class next week. That is my lesson. I gave brief thinking, novel approaches, and motivate them to do this. Then everybody read the lesson, chapter, summarize it, and coming with the presentation slides and ready to do. Then randomly I select, okay, you go and do the presentation. So what is going to happen? Everybody has to read. Everybody has to make their presentation and ready. And everybody is learning. Not me, they are learning. And they have to communicate in front of all 130, become good communicators. Very simple. So those are the techniques we have to learn. Then on the third week, by using the same book framework, they have to make a plan, and within next 12 weeks, they should deliver a result for me by using a plan and delivering a result. So what was the plan? So they, few students, one group, decided to collect 150,000 rupees and deliver a bus hold. For all these things, I am giving marks. If they come to the class, they are entitled for 10 marks. And presentation and teamwork balance 40 marks. So 50 marks allocated for those things, and final exam given the balance. Actually, 60-40. Then that bus halt is in front of Rajagiriya Food City. You can see NIBM bus halt. One team did that. The one team reduced the water bill and electricity bill of the NIBM by changing the student behavior. Lot of people were not using the lift. And one team produced a software and sold it. So now you can see, even art faculty can do this. So our minister is asking, we are producing Janasandhivedini, mass communication graduates, but they have not written a Maranadhanima to the newspaper. Adugana Maranadhanima Kalyaladhani, mass communication students like that. So why? Who is responsible for that? So we have to change that. So therefore, likewise, medical faculty also can do many things. So what kind of graduates do we need? Globally employable graduates, most up-to-date and appropriate knowledge, not only foreign, also the local knowledge. Theory plus practice, practical and pragmatic, and results-oriented, innovative and creative, not complaining about problems, but problem-solving, resolving, people are needed. A lot of graduates are used to complain. That is not good. And good in communication with leadership and teamwork. This is the type of graduate we should produce. Since I have a very limited time, I am not going to give examples much. So, characters of a good leader: integrity, creativity, vision, judgment, communication, knowledge, honesty, fashion, charisma, all these things, soft skills. All these things are related to the soft skills, your teamwork. Again, one more slide says the same thing. Clear goals, good examples, vision, clear communication, expect the best, support, encouragement, etc., etc. Then again, good leadership, purposive, effective, ethical, and satisfied. Again, talking the same thing. Then, especially medical people are not producing any product. You are in service. So delivering a professional service is a very important thing. So what are things you have to have? demonstrating personal qualities, working with others. If you cannot be a good teamwork player, team player, you don't get even led to. If you are doing private practice, they never come to you if you are not good in working with others. And managing services, improving services, and setting directions. You should be a good visionary leader. Then, if I expand this demonstrating personal qualities, acting with integrity, continuing personal development, also you have to learn many things and develop yourself, managing yourself and developing self-awareness. So there are many things I have to say you, tell you, but I am not going to explain all these things. Then this plus vision and strategy has to be a supporting thing to make you a good leader. The role of a medical leader, if you want to become a very good medical leader, the right credentials plus the right experience. Effective communication and relationship building skills. Again, relationship build, communication and relationships. The ability to react proactively rather than reactively. What do you mean proactively? You expect it and get it ready for that. And experience in medical informatics and information ICT. Medical informatics should be one area you should develop yourself. A big picture, not just internal, the outside thinking. The helicopter view. Go out and see the world, see the university. You see environment, then come in and do the changes and go and do the things. So big picture has to be seen by leaders. Something different format, again, thing. So there are two types of leaders. The managers, these are the qualities, focusing on things, do the things right, as I told you, plan, organize, direct, control, and follow the rules. They are not willing to break the rules, especially registrars, bursars, people like this, so they are the set managers. But we need more leaders. So if you can convert this bursars, registrars, and all these others as leaders, so these are the qualities. I'm not talking about you. Focus on people. Instead of things, you should focus on people. Then do the right thing. Do the right thing. Then inspire the people. Instead of plan, we have to inspire the people. Influence the people. Motivate the people. Build instead of control. And shape entities. To shape the future. So that is the leader. So maybe we have many managers, but very few leaders. So that is why our country is like this. So we need more and more leaders from bottom to up. So since I have spoken many things about do the right thing, I'm going to ask you a question. Maybe I have asked this question from these professors once. So these professors in front of this rows are not entitled to raise the hand because I have to break the monotony. So father and son went in a car, met with an accident. So answer, don't shout, just raise your hand. Father and son going in a car, met with an accident. It was a fatal accident. Father died on the spot. Tata etharam varana. The son was rushed to the hospital and he was ready for the operation. He was lying on the operation bed and surgeon came with gloves and mask and everything. And surgeon says, I cannot do this operation, my son. Father is dead. So surgeon says, he is my son. How can you explain this? Anyone who knows the answer? Okay, one gentleman, two, three. Okay, what is the answer? Yes. The answer was surgeon versus mother. Surgeon versus mother. But you couldn't find this very simple answer. Why? Why? Because your paradigm. Mindset was surgeon equal
male. හැමලෙම සර්ජන් කෙනෙක් වෙන්න පිරිමියෙක් කියලා හිතන තාක්කල් you never get the right answer. So that is the culprit. So be careful. So most of our top leaders, top people's mindset are old. They have not updated. So believing it is correct, they are giving the wrong answers. Believing it is correct, they are giving the wrong answers. Therefore, mindset. If you want to do the right thing, you have to update mindset or paradigm. So that is one of the key areas I'm going to highlight today from now on. Because otherwise, if you don't read, if you don't update, I have 5-6 days to this materials to talk about this, but I'm not going to talk all these things. Anyway, so do the right thing is very important, but you have to update yourself. 7 habits of medical leaders, National Health Services London survey, and NHS London Leadership Development Mentoring Program for doctors, and some invited guests has done this survey. These are the main 7 habits if you want to become a good medical leader. Bravery and resilience. So you have to have guts to say something and take it forward. Most of our people, leaders, don't have this bravery. So if the majority says something, yes, yes, I'm also helping. Don't do that. Why? Whenever you try to do something new, always there's a resistance. So you know that. Galileo is the one who's declared world is round, but all the other people thought flat. So if you accept others, you don't know, yes, yes. But so majority decision is not always correct. Don't accept that. Therefore, if you want to become a good professional leader, bravery and resilience is the key. Then mentoring, having a vision, optimism, developing networks, clinical credibility, recognition of opportunity, all these things. So you can go to the web and find out these things. So since the web is there, don't worry. You can learn a lot. Unfortunately, most of the people don't go to the web and read. Just given the all things. So then you are not going to be a good leader. Read, update. So Mr. Lalit Veerutunga told me at least he is reading 1 hour every day. In my case, I read at least 2-3 hours every day. Otherwise, we cannot lead. We cannot tell others a good thing, new thing. So that must be a good habit. So challenge for senior leaders, finding this kind of people is the key. I am not going to all this spell out. Then, there are 3 types of managerial skills. Start from the bottom, technical skills. Job-specific skills required to perform a particular type of work. You want to become a doctor? It's there. Surgery? Yes, there. Dentist? Yes. Technical skills? There. ICT? Yes. But the important is the human skills. The ability to alter, lead, and control the behavior of other individuals and groups. Not to agree with them, but to control and manage them with the human skills. That is lacking. So as a leader, if you are good in human skills, you can motivate them and inculcate them to think alike. Not leader is adopting others' ideas. So you should communicate, and not by force, by logically, let them accept. That is the key. Then conceptual skills. The ability to analyze and diagnose a situation and distinguish between cause and effects, and strategic thinking and mindsets. Strategic thinking is the key. So technical skills are there, but lacking part is the human skills and conceptual skills. So if you want to become a good leader, good professional, effective leader, you have to have this human conceptual skills. Of course, technical skills is a must. So this is the way. The first line managers, low level managers, less conceptual skills. When you go further, you have to have more focus on conceptual skills. Human skills, same. The technical skills, you have to have more. When you go to the top, You don't have to have much technical skills. This is the model. So these are the things you have to learn and practice to become a good leader. Then we are going to introduce this KSAM. What is KSAM? So if you want to become a total graduate, you have to be a KSAM graduate. That is, K stands for knowledge, then skills, you can see the photographs, the attitudes, values, and vision. I have added vision also. You have to have a good vision. So good attitude, good values, and good vision. Now, in our universities, vision is given by someone else. But lecturers should have some new visionary thinking to the students, in addition to the knowledge and skills and attitudes. Sometimes some vice-chancellors, not here, are coming and telling me, sir, our students' attitude is very bad. I'm asking in return, who is responsible for that? So developing attitude is also part of the game. We cannot negate that. So we have to include that attitude and the mindset. I told you, the mindset or the paradigm updating. Therefore, you can see a photograph here. What is the photograph you can see? Some people who can see a bird. Is anyone can see a bird? No? Yeah? You can see a bird. Some people can see a rabbit. So how you see the world, how you perceive the world is very important. If you see the wrong world, then you believing it, you give wrong decisions. Therefore, updating mindset is also important. So if you want to become a top, KSAM is the key. So try to become a KSAM graduate. Are we producing it? Is our question. At the Ministry of Higher Education, UGC, deans, vice chancellors, all should ask question from ourselves whether we are producing a KSAM graduates. Or just half K graduates. Some faculties are producing only half K, that is only knowledge. That is theory. Again, outdated theory. So theory and practice. Knowledge has two sections, theory and practice. Definitely, doctors have to learn theory and practice in the hospital. But some faculties don't. The fundamental and special capabilities, skills, the attitude and values, and the mindset. So we have to question by ourselves, have we inculcated and developed our curriculum with these all four areas? If not, please. Let's do it. It's very important. In sum, a confident person who has a strong sense of right and wrong, is adaptable and resilient, knows himself, is discerning in judgment, thinks independently and critically, and communicate effectively. So are we producing a person? And are we testing these things? Can we test just let him writing answers on the script? So we have to change the testing methodology also. So when we test the people, we have to check whether these things are there. That is important. A self-directed learner who takes responsibility for his own learning, who questions, reflects, and preserves in the pursuit of learning. He cannot stop learning. Continuous learning, every day 1 hour, go to web and learn something. You cannot stop. You become obsolete. Then active contributor, who is able to work effective in teams, exercise initiative, take calculated risk, is innovative and strive for excellence. Always trying to raise the bar. And a concerned citizen, who is rooted to Sri Lanka, has a strong civic consciousness, is informed and take an active role in bettering the life of others around him. So if he can produce a person with all four categories, confident person, self-directed learner, an active contributor, and concerned citizen, that is what we expect. So that is the art of the university, we believe. So finally, I'm going to spell out the 8 given by the Stephen Covey, Everybody has a body, mind, heart and spirit. You all do this called total human paradigm, but still we are managing people with industrial paradigm. We just passed the industrial paradigm, we are trying to manage people, the knowledge worker, with industrial paradigm, based on industrial paradigm. It's wrong. We cannot motivate people. So now we are dealing with the knowledge worker. Knowledge worker has to be managed with total human paradigm. So what are the contents of that total human paradigm? The body, to live, heart, to love, mind, to learn, and spirit, to leave a legacy. So how can we relate it to the organizational capacity? Body to live, pay me a reasonable salary. So we have to give them a reasonable salary. But salary alone will not motivate them to work. Then heart to love, treat me kindly. Most of our leaders still don't know how to treat the people kindly. So kindness is very important. If we don't treat them kindly, their heart is sick, they are not get motivated. Therefore, reasonable salary plus treat them kindly is a must. We have to shift our mindset, our action. How you think, act. So our action is purely based on our mindset. Then the mind to learn. Use me creatively. Lot of people has a lot of new ideas, novel ideas, novel thinking, but we are not allowing them to come up with. That is a sin. Because everybody want to give new novel ideas. But unfortunately, we even though we ask for novel ideas, they are not coming with their novel ideas also. That is also a problem. So anyway, if you satisfy your employers, you have to give a reasonable salary, you have to treat them kindly and use them creatively, allow them to bring their own ideas, discussion, new thinking. And spirit, leave a legacy. Contribute to the society in ethical manner. Everybody wants to do something for their country, for their society. And we have to tell that, okay, how we are going to do that? How medical faculty is contributing to the society? How Java is contributing to the society, nation? Then people get happy, not profit. Unfortunately, most of the organizations are talking only about the profit. Profit maximization is highly outdated concept. So how we contribute to the society, how we contribute to the nation, then people get and come up. Unfortunately, this part has been completely neglected. How LTT is sending their people to get suicide, not through money, but through education. Are we using that vision power to motivate our people? No. Use that. That is the most important power. Unfortunately, left-wing people only they are using that mindset change of visionary thinking to motivate the students. University should start giving that thinking to the students. So body, heart, mind and spirit. All four areas have to be satisfied of all employees. Then they become real human beings. They become things. We should not manage things, but we should manage people. So if you want to become a good leader, think all these things and read. So I will finish my lecture by giving this nod. Last will of a father. The story is this. There was a father who left 17 camels as the inheritance for his three sons. When the father passed away, his sons opened the last will. The will of the father stated that the eldest son should get half of 17 camels, while the middle son should be given 1/3. The youngest son should be given 1/9 of the 17 camels. Now, they couldn't resolve this problem because 17 cannot be divided. So they went to a wise man. So if you are the wise man, so what is your, how do you resolve the problem? Is the final question for me, for you. If you are the wise man, so the three sons decided to go to the wise man. The wise man listened patiently about the will and gave a nice answer. Is there anyone who can give the correct answer or nice answer, you are the winner. I will give you 1,000 rupees. Okay, you will surprise. You see the answer. That is third old radio. Because when we take decisions, we always forget to think out of the box and go for a third old radio. Therefore, my final lesson for you to think of a third old radio always. Don't limit to the yes, no, or two old radios. What is the third old radio? Is the wise man, after giving this thought, brought one camel of his own and added the same to the 17th. Then increase 18. Now division is easier. The first son getting half, that is 9. The second son getting 1/3, that is 6. The third son getting 1/9, so 2. Then add up 9 plus 6, 15, plus 2, 17. Now add this up. So problem is resolved and he got his camel back. So that is the third old radio. So if you are thinking out of the box and looking for third old radios, we can find always a solution. Don't think we cannot resolve problem. Unfortunately, we ourselves block our mindset and say no. Don't do that. Be open and go for a third old radio. So final remarks, a great choose the path, others will follow. So main points, try to be a KSIM graduate or professional, and are we producing them is the question we should ask. Our input, process, output and monitoring system. Check whether we have designed to produce KSIM graduates by the university, faculty, department and your lecture. And technical human skills plus conceptual skills, are we giving properly? Human paradigm, body, heart, mind and spirit, and total graduates, and finally look for the third old radio. So then any leader, a great leader, choose the path others will follow. Not you are not following the others, but most of our leaders following the majority who think out of the outside of the obsolete thinking. The most of the things or ideas from the majority is not correct, because sometimes they think based on old paradigm. Paradigm shifting also a must. Okay, in the future, I am sure you all are going to be professionals plus effective leaders from this great faculty of medical sciences of the great university, that is University of Java Tripura, who really can make a difference and impact to you and your families, to the university, to our society and our country, and finally to the world. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity. Good, and wish you all the best. And thank you very much, the great leader, our Dean, Faculty of Medicine. I think he's trying to do a lot of things. And with the Vice Chancellor, and with other deans and respect the faculties. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.